If you are breathing today, give Jesus the praise. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm talking about shoes, biblical meaning of shoes in the dream. I'm also going to talk about four types of shoe dreams. I'm sure you've had dreams about shoes, and that's why you're watching this video. As a woman, I love shoes. I feel so confident when I'm putting on nice shoes, and I'm sure it's the same with you. When you hear the word shoes, what comes to your mind? Beautiful, like I've said. Putting on shoes makes your outfit complete. Shoes in the Bible symbolize beauty. You look beautiful when you put on shoes. Songs of Solomon 7 verse 1 talks about how beautiful are your feet in sandals. And shoes symbolize direction, the path you are taking, preparedness. It means that you are ready. There are many times that I will be going out and I'll tell my daughter, put on shoes. Every time I have to tell her to put on shoes. So it means that you can't be out there without shoes. If you don't have shoes and your shoes are missing, you won't go. You make sure you look for those shoes. If you have another pair of shoes, you are going to just get another pair and put on. And shoes symbolize progress, moving forward, protection, determination, friendships, marriage. It means restoration, like the prodigal son. When he went back to the father said, get the best gown, the ring, and the best sandals. So without shoes, restoration was not going to be complete. You can read about that in Luke chapter 15, verse 22. So you can see here now that not having shoes simply means you are not protected. You cannot be ready to preach the gospel. You are not ready to move, to progress. It means that it's a spirit of backwardness. You are going backwards and backwards because you don't have shoes. You are confused. Anytime that you don't have shoes, you have to look around. You have to be so stressed. It means that the situation is not good. Hardship. When you don't have shoes, what happens? Really is the opposite of good. It's the opposite of anything good. Now let's look at the four types of shoe dreams. Dream number one, losing shoes in the dream. Your shoes are missing. Both of them are gone. You want to dress up. You are going for a function or an event or interviews or anything in the dream. And you want to put on your shoes. You look for them. They are missing. They are robbers in the spirit. Sorry to tell you that you cannot overcome such dreams or win against spirits like this with a two-minute prayer. Losing shoes is a staunch spirit. It's showing you that there's a spirit of poverty, backwardness. If you're at work or you have your business or you are in marriage, it goes everywhere. Losing shoes in the dream simply means hardship, demotion. It means shame and disgrace. Your marriage will be in problems. Your finances will be affected. You won't have progress. Remember what I've listed, protection and progress and determination and beauty and all these things. It means that the enemy has robbed you of all these good things. Remember, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. He steals through dreams. So when your shoes are missing in the dream, just know that trouble has arrived. When you don't have shoes, it's hardship. When you are walking without shoes, your life is hard. It's tough to walk without shoes. I've walked without shoes before when I was young. When it's hot, your feet are burning. When you are walking without shoes, you can get hurt. And that is hard. When you see a dream like that, it's not time to sit. Hey? It's time to wake up. Do something about it. You can even go into prayer and fasting. Many times I've done that. When I see a nightmare that is so scary, I'll go straight into prayer and fasting. That's why you, as a child of God, you have to always be ready to pray and fast. Fast against such spirits. Because if you don't, what comes next can rob you off of everything good you've ever worked for. If that resonates with you, comment in the comment box below, share your testimony, share your experience, and it will help someone. And let's go to dream type number 2, which is buying new shoes in the dream, or someone gives you new shoes. That is a good dream, and there's nothing to worry about. You know, when you have a dream like that, what happens? You feel good. Somebody gives you new shoes, you feel great. That is something nice. And anything good comes from God. Anything that is good comes from God. When you have a nightmare, it comes from the devil, because now you are scared, you are fearful, and the whole day you are haunted. So new shoes means new beginning, a new start. You are going into a new season. A breakthrough is about to come in your life. You are breaking forth. It means that your prayers have been answered and all the wonderful things. It's a new start. So be ready to celebrate. God is still using dreams today to communicate with you, to tell you what is about to happen. He did it in the old and is still doing it today. And if you can go and read Job 33, verse 14 to 18, it's clear that God still uses dreams to speak to us. But the enemy also uses dreams to wreck your life, to attack you, because you are sleeping and there's nothing much you can do about it. If your spiritual life is not strong, you find that you are losing every time you are attacked, you are beaten by a snake, or you are attacked by witches. So this is where now you wake up and say, I have to up my game here. If I haven't been praying hard, I have to pray. You know, but God is always on your side and will give you victory. Sometimes these dreams are there to push you to your next level, so that you realize, hey, I'm too comfortable here, and let me start to pray even more. Number 3, dreaming about cleaning shoes. Dreaming about cleaning dirty shoes, or maybe they are dusty, but you are cleaning shoes in the dream. It simply means that you have to make some changes in your life. It means that you are determined to change. You are looking at doing something different for your own good. You want to go in the right direction. This dream is not all bad, it's not all good. It may mean that you are lukewarm, you are neither hot or cold. You are in the middle, and this is confusion. So if you are in the middle, God says that he will spill you out of his mouth. This is not me, it's God. So you have to check your life. When dreams come like that, God is saying something. It's not always the devil. Sometimes God is saying, look, your life is lukewarm, it's in the middle. You are not completely on my side. How can I defend you? I want you to be completely in my kingdom, and then I'll clean up your life so that you can move forward. Whatever story you have, God wants to use you. And these dreams, they don't just come. God is giving you a message. So look at your life and say, I'll clean up the side. God is not going to do it for you. You can ask God to give you the grace to help you overcome certain weaknesses. But you have to take action. You have to say, no, I'm not going to live like this anymore. I'm not going to be a Christian that is so weak and I cannot pray, I cannot read my Bible, and I'm expecting God to just throw answers from heaven. It's not going to happen like that. The enemy is busy. So cleaning shoes means that there's a willingness to change. You want to obey God. You want to do the right things. If it's in your personal life, probably you want to do right in your marriage. You want to make your life better in any area of your life. And what do you do in that case? Ask God to give you the grace. Because it's not by might, nor by power, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the power that will move you forward. And anything that you feel like you cannot do on your own, ask the Holy Spirit. He will empower you to move forward. He will give you the confidence. Remember in Acts chapter 2, where they were given the Holy Spirit. Peter, who could not speak to many people, he was able to preach the gospel because of the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit is going to help you clean those shoes. Wake up and say, I dreamt this dream and I know the meaning. So it means this, and God help me to change. The last one is when you dream that you're wearing two different shoes, two different colors or different shapes or whatever, but it's not the same shoes you're wearing. One side is a different shoe and the other side is a different shoe. That kind of a dream, what do you think it means? When you see someone wearing two different shoes, it means confusion. It means the person is in a rush. You can only wear two different shoes when you are being rushed, when something has happened and you want to run very fast, like when there's an earthquake, you know, or there's war and they are shooting and they are saying, get out of your homes. You will get anything and put on your feet because you want to run fast. As long as it fits, you go, because you at least you want to go out there wearing some shoes. When it's dark, that can happen. What does it mean spiritually? It means that probably your life is not stable. You are in confusion. You don't know which path to take in your marriage, in your business, with your children, or at work. Sometimes you are in this relationship and you don't know which path to take, and you start to have those kind of dreams. It means that God is showing you, look, there's confusion here. God is a God of order. And if you say, Lord, help me, He's going to help you. Sometimes we lean onto our own understanding and things now don't work out. The solution there is to run to God. When there's confusion in your life, you lose everything because you go 10 steps backwards. Instead of progressing, you go back. Where there's confusion, there's no direction and there's no focus. So you spend days and days, weeks and months and years in that confusion without finding solution. So now, if you know that this is the meaning to whatever you are dreaming, you are able to pray right. It's either you cancel those dreams or you say, God, help me to bring them to pass. I love this dream. Lord, I thank you for what you are doing in my life. Let it be so. Like receiving new shoes in the dream or buying new shoes. It's a new beginning. You say, Lord, I thank you that you are starting something new in my life. May it be so in the name of Jesus. Any negative dream concerning shoes, go into prayer and fasting. Pray about it. It's your life. You want those things to stop. So go into fasting. Don't waste time. Go into fasting and pray against any spirit that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And God will give you the grace to fight back until you recover everything that has been stolen from you in the name of Jesus. If you found this video helpful, give it thumbs up, share it with your friends, comment, and like this video, and be blessed.